Valerie. I'm a pet care advisor, and I'm here with my friend Tubbs. Tubbs is a teddy bear hamster, and we're going to be talking about hamster food. Hamsters are domesticated relatives of wild hamsters, and in the wild, a hamster diet would consist of grains, seeds, possibly some vegetables from a neighboring farm field, insects, and dried grasses. Commercially prepared diets are going to come in a variety of types. Some diets consist of, this is like a piece that has all of their needs nutritionally in it. I don't know if you can see here, they're just these little donuts, and that's all there is. It's just like a dog food or a cat food, and all of the nutrition is in that piece. The only problem with this, while it's a very healthy way to feed, they can't pick and choose out highly fatty treats like sunflower seeds or something and only eat those. When you give them a diet that's this nutritionally balanced, it sometimes can be boring. Rodents are intelligent and they thrive on variety to stimulate them, so something like that would really be a little bit boring for them. You probably want to give them more of a variety to choose from. Rodents can also have the ability to naturally control their dietary needs. If they seem to know that if they need more protein or they need more carbohydrates, as long as you're providing a variety, they will eat what they need. They're very self-sufficient that way. So some of the other diet choices are going to have some grain, some seed, some beans, like legumes, all in the dried form, and we have a variety of those to show you here. So actually the best thing you could do would maybe be to combine different foods, but if you want to pick one consistent diet, these are some healthy choices to go with. Now these diets over here have some of the more fun foods in them. They have dried fruits, they may have nuts, and those are fattier, so you may want to, you know, make sure that in each serving you're sort of limiting the consumption of the fattier foods. The dried fruits, such as like banana chips and raisins, those offer you the ability to feed fruits and vegetables in a convenient shelf-stable sort of method. Probably what is a better method to get fruits and vegetables into your hamster is to provide fresh fruits and vegetables. I'm going to have a list of some recommended fruits and vegetables that you would feed your hamster on this blog so that you can see what's recommended. You want, you know, a small portion of fruits and vegetables. You don't want to feed them too much because they can actually get diarrhea from too much of the, you know, the moisture in the fruits and vegetables. But another thing that is very healthy for hamsters are the dried hay grasses such as oat grass, botanical hay, things like that, Timothy hay. A little handful of this is good. The amount that you want to feed your hamster, your pelleted food or your seed mix would probably be about that much. It's just a couple of tablespoons. Tubbs is going to check that out. And then the quantity of fruits and vegetables, I have here some romaine lettuce, some chopped up apple, string beans, and cucumber. That's about all you'd want to feed. That's just a little teeny, you know, maybe a tablespoon of that a day. But what time of day should you feed the hamster? There's some differing opinion on that. Because they're nocturnal, they would be in the wild. They would stay underground most of the day through the heat of the day, and they would go out foraging for food at night. So some experts say that you should feed them at night, but the thing is, they're not necessarily eating while they're foraging at night. They're storing the food in their cheek pouches and bringing it back to the nest. And then during the day, they'd be napping throughout the day, waking up for periods of nibbling on the food that they gathered the night before. So you probably want to just feed about this much food, put that into the cage, and then about 12 hours later, check and see how much is left. Use that as a gauge because each hamster is going to have a different activity level, a different metabolism. So it's difficult to say exactly how much a hamster should eat, but you just want to pay close attention. Some people will just mound this bowl up and keep it that way, and that way you have no idea how much food the animal's actually eating. You can also offer treats such as protein treats like hard-boiled egg, they say. Small bits of hard-boiled egg is okay. Even dry cat or dog food, just one or two pieces, it actually can help groom the teeth and provide a little extra protein boost. So I hope you found this helpful, understanding that hamsters can have a wide variety of foods. They have a pretty hearty digestive system. When introducing new things, you probably want to go gradually, but they can handle a lot of different types of foods, and they really need that variety to keep them engaged and interested in their food. Thank you very much.